All right, joining me in studio now is NCIC Commissioner Dr. Danvers Makori. Thank you so much for coming in, Commissioner.
Thank you for having me.
Every election cycle, we have NCIC issuing warnings about hate speech, but it seems they don't seem to drive home or get the message to those who are offenders. Why is that?
Vicky, thank you for having me. And it's true what you've said. The reality is just a few of them. And then it's an unfortunate incident we have with Senator Linturi, what he said, and where he said it. And I think I'm glad at least he issued an apology statement, as you can put it. Yes, we see it that way. 8 months to election, and we're getting concerned if this is what is happening now. But we've had engagement with politicians, and that's a fact. Behind the scenes, one-on-one on them, we've had measures, some of them which you can say here, but we have engagements so to be preemptive and proactive. We don't want to react like this now. Of course, you have to do what you have to do when something like this happens. But what we have done in the past and what we're doing even now is engagements behind the scenes with them, and we have a series planned even on the public setting with them so that we don't have to go through or hear what has happened.
But even with Senator Linturi's apology, some would argue that the damage has been done. You know, a lot of what he had said, you know, went online, but in terms of his tracking back what he said, wasn't reaching the people on the ground who actually heard him utter those words.
Partly true, yes. But if words incite, also words can heal. The same person who incites is the same person who tells his people to stand down. And that's why apologies are important. And he did it in his own volition. You know, usually they come and we do a statement with them, then they issue an apology. When it's immediately the date happened, he actually did it, and I commend him. But I agree with you, damage is done, and that's where the contention is, because sometimes, and you've seen it actually on social media, people saying, well, he meant this. In communication, you're an expert in communication, it's not what you say that matters, what is meant, what is understood that matters. And what is understood on the ground in people in Albagon, in people in Joro, in people in Molo, in people in Moiben, what they understood by that is very different than what he meant. However, he's amen. So the damage is done, yes. And we hope, we've had a series of engagement, especially in these regions, to reinforce peace and cohesion. So hopefully what we've done in the past can will pay now, so that those communities can understand that they have to continue to work in harmony and peace.
I mean, can it work fast enough? I know NCIC began what it called the wall of shame.
Yeah.
So hate mongers were put on the list. That's a social consequence.
True.
It's not something that will put them behind bars. Has it yielded anything?
Yes, it has. Because if you notice, this is the first time something in this scale has happened since we started that. Mm-hmm. Because what happened in the past, and I can tell you, we had many, many politicians call us, say, you know what, I don't want to be part of it, and therefore I will be peaceful. I will engage in a discourse that is constructive. So it did work, actually. It was a deterrence, and we actually did achieve its consequence. What the senator said, I think it was David New tweeted today, saying that politicians, when they get a microphone in a crowd, they kind of lose their sense. Mm-hmm. And it happens many times, because that's what they tell us, and we saw it. But it has actually worked. For the whole year, we haven't seen such rhetoric in the public space, in the public discourse.
Have any of those on that list, on that wall of shame, been prosecuted at all?
Prosecution takes a while. Mm-hmm. But as you said, you know, the reason we had that list of fame and shame was both a reward for those who really work behind the scenes and even publicly to build cohesion and peace, but also deterrence, so that those who participate, those who incite, have a deterrence aspect to it. So it wasn't so mostly as a prosecution aspect of it, although we have, two individuals who their cases right now, their files right now with the DPP. Actually, one actually is in court. There's a case right now in court that we actually had mentioned. The reason actually the individual was cited was because his case was already actually in court.
Well, that will actually be the thing that speaks volumes when it comes to hate speech in this country, and at least before the elections begin.
Absolutely, that's true. And that's why, just a quick one, and that's why we're actually with the judiciary. If you saw the other day, the Chief Justice, we had a meeting with her, and she agreed to have 5 courts just on hate speech matters to fast track these cases so that they don't take, they take 5 years. So now we will, 6 months, cases are in time, so that we don't have that going on again.
Make an example out of the offenders. Thank you so much, Commissioner, for your time.